Hello everyone. This is a video response concerning infant surgical assignment, reassignments, surgical abuse on people who are born just a little differently, not appearing as normal boys or girls, sometimes just being something that's just kind of in between, you know, not really one or the other, having physical appearances, genitalia, that doesn't match the medical definition standards for normal appearing genitals, and for people who are also identified later on in life, like at puberty or adulthood, and found to be intersexed, to possess a genetic hormonal variation or receptor defect, that makes them intersexed. I've watched many of the documentaries, blogs, that people have posted, and I've commented on a few, and I want the world to know that I'm intersexed. You know, I was born different. Thought to be a girl, found out to be a boy, or an almost boy. You know, doctors thought I was a girl because that's what I appeared most likely to be. Lab work said, no, there's a Y chromosome. Sort of there. I'm actually 46XY, 45XO, gender mosaic, male. I was reassigned. I can't even say that correctly. I was reconstructed male. A lot of the development that I possessed that made me appear as a girl was removed, sewn shut, penile reconstruction, a lot of internal rewiring, and not all of it is an infant. I think that might make me a little different than a lot of the people that you've read or seen. I've had several surgeries in my adulthood, 18 years of age, and again at 31 years of age. That has the same surgical implications, the same mental trauma, having surgery without consent, being in the hospital for other surgical health matters. That could have been life-threatening. One was, and you know, it, you know, having surgery for another issue, and having doctors decide, you know, this is a boy, or I should say this is a man, and you don't deserve to have boobs. you shouldn't have breasts. You know, I carry scars from 18 years of age, because I don't know if it was my mom, most likely my parents, who had been pushing for several years to have my chest reduced. And it wasn't even that big. You know, you can call it the man boobs if you like, in my teen. And I wasn't obese like I was back then, or like I am now. Back then I was actually quite fit. But my hormones growing up were just a little different. You know, the estrogens were a little high for a boy, and the testosterone was a little low. You know, so I kind of understand what people have gone through who are intersexed. I understand what it's like to not trust doctors, to have almost no faith at all in the medical community, because of a history of doctors treating you like what I thought of myself, and they ignored it. I was questioned most of my life, if I was happy as a boy growing up, repeatedly, every physical, every time I got sick and went to the hospital. You know, I was told I was sterile as a man, 15 and a half years of age. I never fathered children, and didn't find out why or how until I was 22 years of age. And I think a lot of people have enough understanding of what something like this, having surgery, without their permission, doctors taking advantage of innocent people who aren't able to express themselves, taking advantage of people even when they are capable of expressing their desires and wishes, all to fit a standard of you're either a boy or a girl. Me, I'm intersex. I'm anatomically a true hermaphrodite. You know, I was 22 years old before I found out how I was a girl, but a boy, or why my blood said I was female, but male at the same time. You know, and I really wish the medical community, doctors, surgeons, psychiatrists, social workers, all mental health practitioners, geneticists, endocrinologists, general practitioners, all of them understood the implications of what a surgery forced onto a person can do to them. You know, I didn't find out until I was 22. You know, my teen years were hectic. They weren't extremely cruel, but there was so many questions by doctors and parents about me being happy as a boy, and me telling them no repeatedly over and over again, and then just being ignored, that a lot of trust was broken. And then when I finally found out with an MRI while serving in the military, and then lab work with that first showed up in congenital adrenal hyperplasia, karyotyping later that came back, XYXO, you know, and being told that, hey, those are ovaries inside, you know, that's a juvenile uterus. Those are undifferentiated motor inducts, my development was kind of a little bit of both, you know, a little bit of male, a little bit of female, mixed together. You know, when a doctor tells you you've had a lot of penile reconstruction, it challenges a person. You know, it changes how they identify and they look at themselves. And often it takes a very long time to recover from finding out. And we all find out. That's probably my biggest angst against doctors and prescribed treatment of intersex people, hiding medical records, surgical surgeries, biopsy reports, gender reassignments, gender reconstruction, to the genitals, hormone therapy, you know, taking pills as a teen, and catching my father dumping, you know, pills from one bottle into a Geritol bottle, and never getting an answer what they were, but me refusing to take them afterwards. There's a lot more to being intersex than just having surgery forced on you as an infant. Often it continues, and I was lucky enough that I went from 18 years of age to 31 years of age without any surgeries being forced on me. But at the same time, I was struggling really, really hard with finding out 22 years of age how I was put together. And I want people to understand that, you know, I'm not an abomination. I'm not a freak of nature. I'm still human, you know. I still have a right to express myself as I want to. And I hope people understand that We're all different. We're all different for a reason. We're not supposed to be the same. Thank you.